Today, while I go and get some cat food and check the mail, I'm going to tell you about what the best rest times are between sets of strength training for maximum strength, hypertrophy or muscular size, and or endurance training. All three. And I'll tell you the best rest periods between all those. So let's go get some cat food. You have to understand the interaction between training variables like intensity, number of sets, rest intervals between sets, exercise modality, and velocity of muscle action. Research has indicated that the rest interval between sets is an important variable that affects both the acute and chronic adaptations to resistance exercise programs. So today for you, I have the data from 35 studies reviewed, both the acute responses and the chronic adaptations, with rest interval lengths as the experimental variable. So in terms of acute responses, a key finding was that when training with loads between 50 and 90%, like most of us do, of your one rep maximum, 3 to 5 minutes rest between sets allowed for greater repetitions over multiple sets. Pretty normal, right? Now in terms of chronic adaptations, resting 3 to 5 minutes between sets produced greater increases in absolute strength. So that's the keeper from that one, due to higher intensities and volumes of training, right? So 3 to 5 minutes there for absolute strength. Similarly, higher levels of muscular power were demonstrated over multiple sets with 3 or 5 minutes versus 1 minute of rest between sets. However, some experiments have demonstrated that when testing maximal strength, a 1 minute rest interval might be sufficient between repeated attempts, but the experience of lifters out there pretty much wouldn't agree with that. Having said that though, the studies did say that from a psychological and physiological standpoint, the inclusion of 3 to 5 minute rest intervals might be safer and more reliable. Now, when the training goal is muscle growth, the combination of moderate intensity sets with short rest intervals like 30 to 60 seconds might be more effective due to greater levels of growth hormone during such workouts. Finally, the research on rest interval length in relation to chronic muscular endurance adaptations is less clear. Training with short rest intervals like 20 seconds to 1 minute resulted in higher repetition velocities during repeated submaximal actions and also greater total torque during a high intensity cycle test. Both of these findings indirectly demonstrated the benefits of utilizing short rest intervals for gains in muscular endurance. However, there is experience with Russian lifters that proves this is incorrect. And I'll link to the Joe Rogan interview with Pavel that goes deeply into endurance training and the rest intervals required to boost your results for that goal. When rest intervals are done correctly, with other important variables like volume and intensity, can influence the efficiency, safety, and ultimate effectiveness of a strength training program. Now, for myself, I like to split the difference for between optimum size and strength and rest 1 to 2 minutes between sets. This usually happens by supersetting antagonistic muscle groups, so like chest and back, by flipping back and forth between each exercise. That's like a built-in timer for me. And so that ends up getting 1 to 2 minutes. And if it's something big, say, you know, deadlift and bench superset, then the rest periods get bigger. So it's cycled in there, giving me 1 to 2 minutes for optimum size and strength. And then if you want to specifically go for more endurance related stuff later, you can just tack that in either on an off day or with a specific training modality after that. Hope that helps. Let me know. Ask your questions below. And don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button if you want to hear more like this.